proud of. So definitely shout out to Arctic for making it this far. And even now, he's doing collaborative events with 2GG. We had Smash Sounds, and now Suplex City coming up on Horizon as well. It's great to see. But speaking of stuff that's great to see, here we go.
Yeah, I made the mistake. It's Supermonic 9000. So DK actually was another character that he did play in 4. So I'm interested to see how his skill has improved here in Ultimate. But right now, going up against Bao, this Wolf here. And, like, you got to talk about the skill of Wolf right now. Like, this is the character that everyone's like, oh, Wolf carry, stuff like that. But I, like, here's the thing. I think that's actually false. I think the player makes the character in almost every sense of the word, no matter the character. And so, Bao, I really want to see what kind of Wolf he has here, because people have a lot of different Wolves. Some have the Bane Punish, some have an aggro Wolf, and I really, like, want to see how Bao decides to play this.
I would always describe Wolf as a sandbox character, right? You're playing GTA San Andreas. Are you going to just beat up a random bystander and take their whip? Or are you going to actually, like, go through the storyline, or maybe try to be nice for once? Who knows, man? You can play it how you want it, and Wolf is one of those characters where you really do have that flexibility. Ooh, wow, and that up smash catching the roll behind. But as you're saying, Super Monic 9000, you know, someone we're trying to see what he has to offer as well. I feel like Donkey Kong does offer a similar kind of malleability, but the only thing he doesn't have at his disposal is he can't really camp.
No, and I that was actually one thing I was going to talk about. The first problem I saw in that first stock was he was really just on the other side of the stage. Bao was just firing that laser at him, and Monic was not able to get a lot out of it. He just kind of sat there and took it, not even shielding it, just taking that damage, and it racked up a lot of damage real quick. So right now, while Bao is at 92%, Monic has to find a way to quickly get damage and get this kill option before he gets up to a high percent, like 96 right there. Monic deciding to recover on stage with that recovery.
Ooh, goes for the, wow, and it gets canceled out by the blaster, I think. But there we go, that's gonna be a throw, gonna run off stage,
meet him. Yep. Not gonna kill just yet. All the way to the top corner.
Ooh, no.
Actually tried for the back air, but covered it. Back throw will kill. Monic at 116% right now. Bao on his fresh second stock.
Going back. Go ahead and recover the 60 up B, but still, you know, quite a bit behind. And man, we got like the slappiest version of the Pokemon Center theme going on right now, right?
This is
the Pokemon
Center. Dude, it slaps. I think all the music in this game absolutely slaps. Minus Animal Crossing, but like, this music, I'm going to, if you take me to any stage, I'm going to F-Zero, either Omega or Battlefield, and I'm playing that F-Zero medley. I'm going to clap right there. But right now, on this Pokemon Stadium, Monic in a little bit of trouble right here. 50% on his last stock, really has to find a quick way to, like, shorten this gap right here.
I mean, yeah, he's trying to figure it out. He's trying to work his way through. But for Bao, he's really been able to kind of use the gun and abuse the gun, right? Infinite bullets, why not let it rain? And until my opposition is able to prove that they're capable of dealing with this camping, I'm just going to stick to it. And especially, you know, it's one thing.
Yeah, look at this. Monic's just taking these lasers, just trying to run straight at him. Not doing too much there.
And it's just, wow, he's just really just eating it. It's the kind of thing where, like, he needs to walk forward and shield. You know what I mean? He needs to walk forward or just jump over it. And like, you know he's going to do it. Just jump over it and go for a move. But it's kind of thing where he's standing under the side platform, and it's making him hard to figure out how he's going to descend with an aerial.
I want you to, like, think about the percentage he was at when you started making that comment, and look where he's at now. 158. He almost took 50 damage from those lasers. Like, he just walked and he ran, really, into every single one of those lasers. Kind of be like, no, now's the time, now's the time, now's the time. He's got to get out those shields, possible parries, and got to find a way to get in a lot easier than just taking these. And that back throw is going to do it at such a high percent.
Yeah, man, I was rough, right? That was rough. Because he couldn't figure out how to get in, right? He was like, all right, he's shooting out these lasers. Laser, 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 laser. And into some extent, that's just very tilting, one, to begin with, right? Like, oh, crap, this person's really trying to lay me out right now. Like, come on, B, I thought we were friends. But no, this is a tournament. We got killers only. And people will do whatever it takes to win, man. People will time people out. People will shoot lasers for 10 years. And it's really up to him to deal that he can prove with it. Or rather, to prove that he can deal with it.
Yep.
And he was just struggling in every way, shape, or form. Could have maybe tried a full hop, over, work his way in slowly. But instead, he keeps committing to the dash. And every time he does that, he's unable to shield at the startup.
Because I think he's wanting to, like, but the only thought process I could have with keep running into it is maybe like a dash attack and hope it like clanks, but it won't clank. Like, the laser will beat it out every time, if I'm correct. But like something like that, he's got to, like you said, full hop, try and mix up the approach options. If you keep committing to a single approach option, your opponent will catch on super quick and punish it every time, like we saw right there. So game two net right now, I really want to see different and mix up approach options coming out from Monic here.
Oh wow, beautiful two frame. punish coming from Bao with that down tilt. He's able to force the scenario once again, almost resets the ledge trapping scenario, but the Nair like hits him in like reverse or something, which is kind of strange. You generally don't see reverse hits in Smash Ultimate, but doesn't really matter at all, right? He's resetting the ledge trapping scenario once again. I'm going to wait, go for a forward tilt, maybe react with an up smash. No, reading a jump in, going for the back air, but not finding it, but still maximum control.
Good job there catching the trip up and getting that grab off of it, get some damage. 50%, but Monic got 128. This is what we got to see right here. What's he going to do about those lasers? Was able to parry one, but got sent off stage once again. The edge, I must say, the edge guarding coming out from Bao is really well so far. Like, he's doing a really good job of edge guarding Monic and not letting him breathe on the ledge.
And then, honestly, even though this looks pretty bad for Super Monic 9000, like, he's not in the worst spot right now. If he's able to use this rage to his advantage, he could have himself in a very great spot. And wow, what
the
an on
stage upbeat.
It has some super armor frames at startup as well. Kind of work his way in there and not care about what his opponent is doing. And now if he has him as a ledge right here, like with that much rage, he might be able to KO with another upbeat by the ledge.
Keeps air dodging into that ledge. That may be something that Bao picks up on soon.
And he gets a little bit of a lucky break right there. Could have very easily been up smash out of shield, confirming the KO, but Bao giving him another chance at life here.
Yeah, air dodging into that ledge. You just gotta mix up that recovery option because, again, opponents, this game is all about mix-ups. You may have one really good option, but if you keep doing it over and over, your opponent's gonna catch on and your opponent's gonna really punish you for it. So this game is all about mix-ups. I wanna see more mix-up from Monic. He decided to get to the platform. That was a really good job to avoid the lasers there. Right now, back in neutral and just getting lasered. What's he gonna do to get away from this?
Damage is being racked up. Bao going ahead and extending this lead even further. Gonna air dodge off stage though. I don't know, that's kind of like instinct sometimes as a player when you get hit off stage. You know, we were mentioning it earlier. When you get hit off stage, you like want to be privy to tech, but you also have to be privy to the move you're getting hit by, right? It's not like he was hitting him with like a down air or a forward air or something, maybe a back air against the stage, some spike. So this needs to be, his hands were a little too hot.
It's a force of habit a little bit. You gotta think, like, depending on where you came from, you like, if you're coming from Smash 4, you have years of experience where being like, where air dodging had no negative effects really. Like, or some, but much less than this. Like, you could air dodge as much as you want. In this game, even if you directional air dodge, not only do you have a lot of ending lag, you get one air dodge and you're done. So you gotta use that air dodge wisely.
Oh, I love it. Just runs from the other side of the stage and starts the whirlwind. This could be a game for Super Monic 9000 if he's able to find those hits. And then, wow, that up smash shield poke. I mean, you saw he had a little skittle of a shield right there.
Oh, gets a little poke right there. Gotta be able to tech. Gotta be ready to tech. Not being able to tech in time. Got hit with that forward tilt. The tilted down the forward tilt. And right now, Monic behind in this right here. Gonna forward. Gonna throw him like that down. Trying to get a two frame, I guess? Is that two frame?
I'd imagine it can. It looks like it hits pretty low. You know, one thing I actually would like to see from Super Monic 9000 is to try to go for a little bit of queso. You know what I mean? Like, go for the cargo throw, carry him off stage, try to, like, down throw him into the stage, see if he techs it. Because we haven't had him do, like, a tech check.
No,
you know
not
what I mean?
Like,
see if he actually knows how to deal with it first before you just don't use it at all.
Absolutely. Right now, Monic in a bad situation here. 66%, and possibly rising. You gotta understand, Wolf's aerials can combo into each other pretty well and also just very damage heavy. So at a high percent right now, this is a very dangerous situation. That forward smash, really safe on shield. It's something Monic's gotta watch out for. Up tilt sending him high. Monic just recovering through the platform.
Oh, and there comes the laser once again. Go ahead and try to work
Tried to grab. Whoa, tried for the side B. That would have done it. Right now, Monic going for another throw into the corner instead of trying to go for like an up.
Oh, wow.
That up smash. Reet. The end of the foot caught it. And that's going to be the game. And that goes to the Wolf.
Man, that's just the thing about like how high up Wolf's up smash hits. Because I think he did a full hop out of shield. It wasn't even a short hop. It was a full hop out of shield. Gonna go ahead and land right here, and he's like, I'm a full off hop, and just catch
them. He wanted to come down with like some sort of aerial, I'm guessing either down air or forward air, hoping like the kind of the fist would come through.
Yeah.
But that up smash is just, it's such a good up smash. I think Wolf has some of the best smash attacks in this game. Like,
I don't even think that's debatable, man. I mean, that down smash, probably the best in the game. That forward smash, safe on block, excuse me, are you kidding me? And then this up smash out of shield, it hits high, man.
Look at that.
Tippy toes, man. Combat boot, steel toe.
Bro, I want a wolf mod where instead of howling, he just yurs.
He yurs? Oh, I don't want that. I don't want that. Next, you're going to edit on Tim's and give him a Yankees hat. I don't need to be there.